Excel has a group of functions that end in if or ifs, plural, and they are statistical functions. If you were trying to locate these functions on the formulas tab, you'd go to statistical functions, which are not easy at the first look. You need to go to more functions and click on statistical. This is where you will find AVERAGEIF and COUNTIF. To find the last one, SUMIF, you need to go to maths and trig, and this is where the SUMIF is located. And what else is easy to locate? Subscribe button, not to miss future content. After seeing those alternative plural ones, you might consider using them instead of these ones. But these are widely used at present, and you're going to be seeing them a lot. And they serve a vital purpose, particularly for analyzing data from lists. And we have here one of those examples. We might want to see what's the average salary of all the full-time people in this list. SUMIF will help us to get a sum of compensation per this status. COUNTIF will help us to get a count of how many employees are each on these statuses. And AVERAGEIF will help us to see what are the average salaries per each status. And now let's see how these things are done. Let's start with SUMIF. We start typing the formula, and we see that there are three arguments: range, criteria, and sum range. Range criteria is the list that we will be searching. The criteria would be full time, and the sum range is compensation. And press enter. Now we can do this for other statuses as well. The only thing we need to do is copy these to other cells. Now let's do the same for COUNTIF. The arguments for COUNTIF are range and criteria. So we'll select the range and select criteria and press enter. And let's copy the formula to other statuses. And the last one is to see what are the average salaries per each of these statuses. So AVERAGEIF, and we have three arguments: range, criteria, and average range. Select statuses, select criteria, and the average range, and press enter. Let's copy the formula to other, and it's that quick. We will cover plural versions of these formulas in the next video, so don't forget to subscribe to the channel not to miss future videos. See you in the next one.